You know, with your beard growing out some, the white hairs on the side there are just like coming at me like spider legs.
Don't talk about my spider legs.
Hey, welcome back to our stupid reactions. You idiots, I'm Corbin.
Did you say reactions?
I don't know. And you can follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Come on, juicy.
It's so juicy.
They wrote us on Patreon, official Twitter account.
Yeah. Thanks for that.
Today, we're reacting to a video, right?
I hope.
It's called the Top 10 Street Foods in...
Hyderabad.
Hyderabad, India.
Cool.
It's this white guy in this video, so don't know what his deal is.
I bet he's British.
Is that your guess?
Yeah, which reminds me, this is totally off topic.
What?
But I posted the acting video a couple of days ago of me in the short film, and I got a bunch of comments of, why haven't you ever thought of trying to get into Bollywood because all of the white actors are so bad? And other things of, why aren't you working in Hollywood? It's like we haven't been trying. What do you think we've been doing all these years?
It's not as easy as just going to a studio and be like, hey,
hey, a movie? I'm a good actor. Why don't you put me in a movie?
It doesn't work like
that. It doesn't work like that.
Sorry, guys.
In fact, talent is not the main criteria, folks.
Sadly not.
There you go.
But yes, so here we go.
Yep. I hope we're going to see delicious foods. I hope this is a great representation. Let's put
of
Hyderabad.
Hyderabad.
Here we go.
Hi, everyone. This is David Hoffman from David's Been Here.
Where
I'm
is
here in Hyderabad, India, you know? My second know. City on my epic 7-city tour of this country. I'm going around with my
that
friend Sam and sharing my
he
top
10 seven
foods
cities?
You have to try in this city. And the best part is we'll be getting to all the food stalls with Uber. This is my first time in Hyderabad.
Uber's
and Uber will make it safe and easy to get around without us having to worry about getting lost. It's super convenient. All I have to do is request an Uber on my app, wait a few minutes for the car to arrive, and hop in. It's as simple as that. My driver takes care of the rest. We're starving right now. Let's go try the top 10 Indian street foods in Hyderabad.
My buddy Sam and I requested an Uber X ride at our Airbnb using the app.
Okay, bro.
And took our first
trip to
the Chinese restaurant in Jubilee Hills. Chutney's is known for their dosas, which is an Indian crepe or pancake made from fermented batter that contains rice and a dark bean called the black gram. It is typically served alongside a potato-based stuffing, a lentil-based vegetable stew called sambar, and various sauces called chutneys. I've eaten lots of dosas in my life, but I have never had a dosa like the one that makes so famous. Their specialty is a giant dosa, an absolute monster that's 4 feet long. I think it's safe to say that Sam and I had our work cut out for us. In addition to being the biggest dosa I've ever seen, it did not disappoint when it came to flavor. The dosa was flaky and incredibly tasty, and was served with so many different malpouring chutneys that made my taste buds and my stomach very happy. The coconut chutney in particular blew my mind. Anyone looking for an epic and memorial dining experience in Hyderabad should look no further than the giant dosa at Chutney's in Jubilee Hills. It's definitely worth it. Even if you're not able to finish it, it was my favorite experience in Hyderabad. After leaving Chutney's, our next destination was just one quick Uber X ride away. Sam and I requested an Uber and headed up to Paradise Restaurant in High Tech City, which we heard serves the best biryani in Hyderabad.
Ooh.
Biryani is a mixed rice dish that contains vegetables, your choice of meats, a clarified butter called ghee, and a laundry list of spices including pepper, cloves, nutmeg, cardamom, ginger, onion, garlic, mint leaves, coriander, and saffron. Sam and I tried 4 different types of biryani: chicken, mutton, egg, and veg with paneer. A type of fresh, unaged cheese that does not melt. Each type was delicious, but the mutton and the veg were outstanding. The combination of spices along with the proteins and vegetables made for a savory and filling meal I won't ever forget. I loved every bite, and Sam enjoyed it so much that he ordered a second round.
The
next day, Sam and I went to UberX and headed to Jamba Road in Mozam Jahi Market Circle, where the famous Ram Ki Bandi food stall is located. There, we found an unusual treat and the third street food on my list, the pizza dosa. Like other dosas, this one is made by lathi and fermented batter on a hot griddle called a tava, and they cook it like a pancake. Oh. But instead of the traditional potato stuffing, his special dosa is made with traditional pizza toppings.
Wow.
I'm not watering, watching them make it. This Italian-infused Indian dish was being prepared right in front of us, and it was phenomenal as I thought it would be. It was crispy, buttery, and dripping with hot, delicious cheese. If you're a cheese lover like me, Ramki Bandi's pizza dosa is a must-have when you visit Hyderabad. Ramki Bandi is also home to the fourth street food on my list,
idli,
a type of savory rice cake. It's made by steaming a batter made of dehusked and fermented lentils and rice. This breakfast item is popular throughout the Indian subcontinent and northern Sri Lanka, and it's typically served with sambar, chutneys, or spicy fish curry. The idli at Ramki Bandi was out of this world. It was soft and spongy and had a very distinct nutty flavor that I enjoyed a lot. Ramki Bandi opens at 3 in the morning and closes 6 hours later. So anyone hankering for a buttery, chewy, Italian-infused Indian treat early in the morning should head over to this food stall in Mozam Jaffe Market Circle for some of the best street food in Hyderabad. With our stomachs once again packed to capacity,
we request
another ride. After we told the amazing UberX driver partner where we wanted to go, we headed off to Ulavachuru restaurant in the Jubilee Hills area of Hyderabad. Here we found our fifth and sixth foods of our list. The first of the two is the bamboo chicken, a type of chicken curry that is prepared by marinating small pieces of raw skinless chicken in several spices, including salt and green chilies,
onion, turmeric, garlic
paste, red chili powder, and ginger paste, stuffing the pieces of chicken into a bamboo shoot, which is then sealed with banana leaves or palm leaves, and then cooked on charcoal for at least 45 minutes. It is usually eaten with rice, roti or naan,
and it's sensational.
It is easily one of the best chicken curries I've ever had in my life. The flavor of the bamboo cooks into the chicken and makes for a truly heavenly dining experience. It is to die for. Also on the menu is a dish called pulao, also sometimes called pilaf. Like biryani, pulao is another popular and traditional South Indian mixed rice dish that contains meat and vegetables. But according to experts in Indian cuisine, pulao is a little plainer, has less complex flavors, and isn't layered like biryani. That said, the pulao at Ulavachuru was fantastic, bursting with signature Indian flavors and a wonderful contrast of textures. Sam and I tried several varieties, each full of vegetables and different curries. It reminded me a lot of a really delicious fried rice. I highly recommend Ulavachuru restaurant to anyone visiting Hyderabad. It's one of the city's best. On our third day, Sam and I requested another quick and reliable ride via the Uber app and continued our Hyderabadi
shocker. He took it
to stop at Taj Mahal restaurant, where we found the seventh dish of this list, the South Indian Thali. Thali is the Indian word for plate and is made up of a selection of dishes served on a large, round platter.
I can't help that.
While Northern Indian Thali is served with bread, Southern Indian Thali is served with rice. I love the experience of mixing the different curries with the rice and eating it with my hands. The flavors were vibrant and fresh. Each bite had me craving more.
That's disgusting.
It may have been a little messy, but there's nothing quite like eating with your hands, right? After we finished up at Taj Mahal restaurant, Sam and I requested another UberX ride, which took us to our next destination, an old-style Iranian cafe near Chaminar Mosque called Namrak Cafe and Bakery, where you will find the eighth item of this list, biscuits and chai. The cafe sells dozens of biscuits or cookies, which are baked in a wood-fire oven. I tried a few of them, including their coconut, chocolate, and cream flavor. These biscuits are chewy, buttery, and freshly made, and they're delicious on their own. But
they're taken
to a whole new level when you dip them into the restaurant's famous Irani chai, a sweet, rich, and creamy tea that is unlike any other Indian chai. The two of them together makes Namrak Cafe and Bakery the perfect place for a delightful snack in between the meals. On the following day, before leaving Hyderabad, Sam and I requested another Uber ride, and we headed out to Minerva Coffee Shop. This coffee house and restaurant is known for having some of Hyderabad's best South Indian breakfast food items, including the
Namrak
food on this list, which is Vada. This crunchy, savory donut seriously blew my mind. I had it with both coconut chutney and ginger chutney. Each bite was like an intense flavor overload that danced around on my tongue
I wish I knew
and
which
had
one
me
was
going
which.
Back for more. The 10th and final food on this list is uttapam. This thing is so much more than your average boring pancake. It comes with cashews and veggies and is a lot thicker than a dosa. The pancake itself is so much similar to an American pancake, except it has so many unexpected flavors. Like the vada, the pancake came with a ginger chutney, which gives you an intense burst of heat on your palate. A creamy coconut chutney, which cools your mouth down nicely afterward, after the sweet, zesty heat of the ginger. This South Indian breakfast was exceptional in every way, and was a unique combination of different textures and flavors I never put together before. But I can't wait to have it again. I honestly could have spent those 3 days eating nonstop.
Those are my top 10 Indian street foods.
Cool, bro. Cool, bro. Do you think he was sponsored by Uber?
I don't know. Either that or he did this right when Uber went public.
To get their stock.
To get their stock going up. Which maybe his video contributed to why they dropped. Because I thought the video was awful.
Yeah, I did.
The foods are great, but his video's awful.
I didn't mind it so much, but
really?
No, I don't.
I want to hear the street.
Well, sometimes the certain videos aren't meant for the vlogging style. They're just kind of informational. I don't really care. But some of those foods look absolutely
delicious. I wanted to see him talking to like a server and the people who actually make it and serve it describing the food, and then hearing him experience it and hearing the din of the background noise of the restaurant.
And make those videos.
I will.
But the one that looked the best to me.
Oh, really? You're going to choose a best one? For you.
Oh, man. The
for
pizza?
You, 100%.
I would eat that in a heartbeat. That looked amazing. Also, I want to clarify something. When I say I don't like eating with my hands,
I knew you were going to go to hands.
It's not that I don't, I think my hands are disgusting. It's the feeling of all that food on my hands that disgusts me.
Yeah, but it isn't just your hands.
No, I would never do it with anybody else's hands. That's absolutely disgusting.
Well, that's a cleanliness thing
yes,
for you.
That's a cleanliness thing.
Yeah.
I don't like other people touching me, much less putting their hands in my mouth.
That's very true.
I do not like being touched.
It's true. But at least you're not like Howie Mandel.
No.
I'm not that.
I'm not that kind of germ. No. But I just, that's not really a germ thing. It's just I don't like people
touching
me. It's a
comfort thing.
I don't like it.
He doesn't, guys, you ready? You've heard this before. And for those of you who are new to the channel.
And yes, my father hugged me.
Yeah. If you're newer to the channel, you've heard Corbin say these things. He doesn't like to eat with his hands. He doesn't like other people to feed him with their hands.
Ugh.
He's not fond of being touched. And he's really not fond, that you may not know this, he doesn't like being in very crowded places. It gives him a level of stress. Yes.
The only anxiety...
We understand about what he's going to experience in India.
The only anxiety I get, and it's actually not so much when there's a... like, because I've been in mosh pits, so I go to concerts, and that's totally different. That doesn't really bother me. But the main thing that bothers me is when there's a bunch of room. This is because I don't get anxiety a lot. When I'm walking down the street and like there's not a ton of people. It's one thing if you just got out of a concert and you know, mm-hmm. there's people that are all around. I still hate it, but it's when there's like not too many and there's somebody like a foot behind me
pressing into you. I'm not a fan of that either. This happened to me this morning.
I will grab my wife, pull her to the side, and I will let them pass.
No joke.
Because I can't stand it.
This happens to me more often than I can express at Starbucks. I'll go in and it'll be really early. There's only one or two people in the entire Starbucks. I set my stuff down on a chair and I go to sit in the chair. This has happened to me. It happened this morning. Of all the places the person could sit, they're not only next to me, their chair is scooched back and they're leaning back. And I'm on the phone with Indrani and I'm like, she knows. She's like, someone's sitting next to you, because my face is like, and it's like, right there. And then I show all of Starbucks. They could be sitting anywhere, but they're right next to me. Don't like that.
Yeah. Eating with my hands, it's like, because a lot of people got upset on the banana leaf. They were like, you trust the chemicals of on the fork over your hand. I'm like, it's not about that. I don't like the feeling of having stuff on my hands.
Oh my goodness.
And it's a different, like if it's a solid like pizza, that's one thing. That I can wipe my hand off real fast.
Yes.
They have, like what he showed in the picture, they have food all over their hands.
Yeah.
That's disgusting.
So were you growing up, were you a tactile learner? Like, did you want to touch trees and touch the ground and touch everything? You did?
Yeah. Huh. But I don't like being dirty. But it's not, it's food.
It's dirty. Anyways, but yeah, the pizza one looked delicious.
Yeah.
I did have a question a while back, I think, about like, because breakfast is huge to me here. I love, in American breakfast is very different from everywhere else in
very
the world.
Very different.
Eggs, bacon,
very
French
different.
Toast, and it's large.
It is, yeah. I had that in Calcutta, yeah. And it was like, wah, wah.
Yeah,
and Ronnie knew, she's like, I'm really, this isn't going to be what you expect,
well, yeah,
I promise you.
And when you go to a different country, you don't want to
eat
more
food. Yeah, of course, you don't.
Obviously.
You don't.
So, like, we go there, and I want to try, like, the local breakfast.
100%. But, yeah, like, she was like, one point, there was a Starbucks that we could have gone to, and I was like, yeah, no, I don't want anything that I can get in the States.
I still might need to get a Starbucks, just because for my energy level, I will need it. You don't know how much coffee I drink. I drink a
What's your average drink that you're sucking on over here, Corbin? What's that thing made of?
Iced venti quad vanilla latte.
Could you explain that to the...
That's four shots of espresso, and that's on top of the one or two cups of black coffee I have every morning before this.
So yeah, he runs on caffeine.
But yes, so, but I will want to have a ton of chai. And I
yeah,
still,
you will.
If
You'll
anybody...
You'll want to take it all the time.
When we come to Mumbai, which we'll probably on the first trip,
it'll
we'll go to a bunch
trip.
Of cities, but we will go
Mumbai
to Mumbai for sure. I've seen a video similar to this one. It's called a street food challenge where you have $100.
Right.
I think I've talked about it before.
$100. $100.
$100. And you have to try to, but you know, they will, because I will, any stupid baby that comes, I will buy you food. I will complete this.
Oh, wait a minute. I thought you personally had to consume $100.
I think that's the challenge, yes.
Yeah.
But I'm going to complete
There's
it with everyone.
There's no way you could consume $100 worth of street food.
Oh, no. But I will do it.
Yeah, just get a bunch of stupid babies out there and treat them.
Oh, I will complete this challenge, I promise you.
Yeah, but the challenge has got to be, you have to eat it.
No, it's just spending $100.
Oh, that's stupid. It's not a challenge.
Do you not want free food? Come to Mumbai. We'll do it. But yes, the video was, you know, but I did enjoy it. That dose is ridiculous. Obviously, we wouldn't come to Salad because it's a South Indian dish.
Yeah.
We will have to try that.
Oh, wow.
We will have to try
it. I want to eat anything and everything that's set in front of me.
Yeah.
Anything.
We come to India, which probably around March-ish.
Yeah, well, probably.
Yeah. Well, it'll give or take a couple days. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Might be end of February. Might be end of March.
Wait, we're gonna be there during Holy Week.
Yes, but it could be like that. Could be beginning
right.
of the trip.
Could be the end of the trip.
We don't know yet. That's what I'm saying.
Right.
But you will probably see a bunch of food videos.
Oh,
because I'm trying
everything.
Even if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna try everything.
Well, yeah.
And I'll bring my plastic fork with me.